Good morning, my dear students. Welcome for the online class. So already for your class, I have taught three lessons. So I don't know how many of you have completed your notes, because only few of the students has sent the notes by taking photo and sending to me WhatsApp. But still many of the students have not completed your fair works. So please, if you have a time, or you should create your own time and prepare the notes and be touch with the syllabus. So already we have discussed three lessons in the history. One is Vijayanagara Empire, Bahumani Adil Shahs, Bhakti cult and the Safi heritage. But today we are going to discuss about one more important chapter in the history, that lesson number 4, Nayakas, Palegaras and the Nada Prabhus. My dear students, already in the first lesson you come to know the Vijayanagara emperors were very strong in the Karnataka, and they are very strong in the South India during the time of Sri Krishna Deva Raya Vadayar rule. So after the fall of Vijayanagara Empire, so many kings, so who were working under the Vijayanagara Empire as a chieftains, they started to become independent. You know that how Vijayanagara Empire lost their power, because Bahumani Sultans made a group attack on the Vijayanagara emperors when Ramaraya was ruling, and they defeated the Vijayanagara Empire and they plundered the wealth. They looted the wealth in a mass, and thereafter many chieftains of the Vijayanagara Empire started to declare they are independent and started to become very powerful, dominant in their local regions. So these all people who were declared themselves as a independent, they are also called as a Palegaras. Some of the places they are called as Palegaras, and some of the places they are called as a Nayakas. So like this information we are going to get in the history. So even the presence of the rulers of Keladi and Mysore states, these are all the subordinate rulers of the Vijayanagara kingdom. So among that, the Palepattus, feudatory kingdoms, grew in Chitradurga, Surpur and Yelahanka. They are called as Nada Prabhus. Like this, in a different part of the Karnataka, they started to become independent. In this lesson, we are going to learn today about only the Nayakas of Keladi, and next we are going to study in the next classes about other chieftains of the Vijayanagara emperors. The Nayakas of Keladi ruled the Karnataka, some part of the region under their control, from the year 1499 to 1763 century. They are also called as a Palegaras. So they were working under the Vijayanagara emperors as a small kings, but during that time they are called as a chieftains, or they are called as a Palegaras. The places which were ruled by these chieftains are called as a Palepattus. Among these chiefs, Nayakas of Keladi and the Nayakas of Chitradurga are very famous, but today we are going to discuss about only the Keladi Nayakas. The Keladi was founded in the year 1499 century during the Vijayanagara period, and later they become independent. These leaders of Kerala were ruling the coastal and Malnadu regions of Karnataka. Which are the areas will come under the Malnadu regions? Either it is Shivamogga, Dakshina Kannada, Udupi, Kasaragod, Kodagu, Hasan and Tumkur, Chitradurga, Dharwad and Uttar Kannada. These are all areas before it was under the control of the Nayakas of the Keladi. Among the Nayakas of Keladi, very famous were only three members. One is Hiriya Venkatappa Nayaka, who ruled from 1582 to 1629 century. And one more person, his name known as very famous in the history of Karnataka due to his the revenue system what he has implemented. He is well known Shivappa Nayaka, who ruled from 1645 to 1660. And one more woman who ruled very bravely in the absence of any male members of their family, her name known as a Queen Chennammaji from 1671 to 1656. Like this information we are going to get about the Nayakas of Keladi. Let we discuss the detail about the achievement and the contribution of Hiriya Venkatappa Nayaka, who ruled from 1582 to 1629. He was well known among the kings of the Keladi. During his time, what he has done? So he took the military expedition till river Chandragiri in the coastal region. With the help of Queen Abbakka Devi, he defeated the Portuguese in Mangalore, and he defeated Adil Shahi force of Vijayapura and established victory pillar in Hanagal. He encouraged all religion in his kingdom, and he was tolerant towards to the other religion. And the second one person who ruled the Nayakas of Keladi and extended the empire of the Keladi Nayakas, he was known as a Shivappa Nayaka, who ruled from 1645 to 1660. Only 15 years he ruled, but his ruling regime was very famous in the history of Karnataka. So he occupied the coastal forts of the Portuguese and got the title Padagadala Odeya. He built strong forts in Mangalore, Bekal and Chandragiri for the security of the kingdom. Shivappa Nayaka was a pious man. Pious man means he was very intelligent, and also intelligent, supporting for to the other religion and the people. He encouraged the traders to Goa, to settle in Goa itself, and he started to provide some land for to the Christian peoples to settle down. He given the land grant for to the Christians to make agricultural activities during his time, and he made a strict rule that the Christian priest should be a local person but not by the foreigner. Means those who have converted to the Christianity in Karnataka, for them he has granted the land for making of agricultural activities. During the time of the Shivappa Nayaka, he brought a good revenue system, land revenue system. It is also known in the history of Karnataka as a Sistu of Shivappa Nayaka. How he implemented this system? The fixation of a land revenue was based on the fertility of the land. So falavattate aadharada mele bhoomiyanna avaru en madidru, so vingadane madidru. About 1/3 of the production was collected as a land revenue. Ondaneya moor amshavanna on the land revenue aagi en maartta idda, collect maadkolta idda bhookandayavagi. This systematic revenue system was called as a Sistu of Shivappa Nayaka. The Sistu Shivappa Nayaka led the development of Malnadu region. Many buried land, which the land is not using for agricultural activities, even people started to use that land for agricultural activities. So like this, he encouraged for to the bringing agricultural practice very effectively during his regime. After the death of Shivappa Nayaka, so one more woman who became very popular in the administration of the Keladi rulers, her name known as a Queen Chennammaji, who ruled from 1671 to 1696. So Queen Chennammaji, the daughter-in-law of Shivappa Nayaka, took over the power after him. Daughter-in-law means what here? So say, she repelled the Mughal army and gave protection for Chhatrapati Rajaram. Who is Rajaram? He is the son of Shivaji. When the Mughals attacked on the Rajaram at the Pune, so he escaped from there and took the shelter under the Queen Chennammaji. Even while the army of the Mughals, when they tried to attack on Chennammaji, she bravely faced the Mughal emperors. The symbol of valuer of sacrifice of Karnataka fought even in the time of Mysore army. The Keladi kings built many temples, Agraharas and Veerashaiva Matas. The Agoreshwara temple in Ikkeri is a famous sculpture. The Mattus were centers of boarding. ಮಠಾಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಗಿನ ಮಠಗಳು ಆಗಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿದ್ದು ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಕೇಂದ್ರಗಳು ದೇ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಜೆನರಸ್ಲಿ ಟು ಆಲ್ ದ ರಿಲಿಜಿಯನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಧರ್ಮದವರಿಗೂ ಆದ್ಯತೆಯನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದರು ಚೆನ್ನಮ್ಮಾಜಿ ಗಿಫ್ಟೆಡ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಚರ್ಚ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಮಂಗಳೂರು ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಶಿವಪ್ಪ ನಾಯಕನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಉಳುಮೆಯ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಚರ್ಚ್ ಹೆಡ್ಗೆ ಭೂಮಿಯನ್ನು ದಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಚೆನ್ನಮ್ಮಾಜಿ ಕೂಡ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಚರ್ಚ್ಗೆ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಡನ್ನು ಗಿಫ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ಲು ಆನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಯಸ್ ವಾರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೈಸೂರ್ ಒಡೆಯರ್ಸ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ವಾರ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಮೆನಿ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೆಳದಿ ಲೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಡೇ ಬೈ ಡೇ ವೀಕ್ ದೆನ್ ಹೈದರ್ ಅಲಿ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಮಿ ಆನ್ ದ ಕೆಳದಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಕೆಳದಿ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಡಿಫೀಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಅಟ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈದರ್ ಅಲಿ ದಸ್ ಹೈದರ್ ಅಲಿ ಮರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಕೆಳದಿ area under his control and brought into a Mysore Wadayar administration. So my dear students, now we come to know the clear information about the Nayakas of Keladi. Still, if you have any doubt regarding to this topic, what today I have explained only about Nayakas of Keladi, you can question and send a WhatsApp to me, so I will answer in the next video. So until, keep watching the video in the next coming days and prepare the self notes if you have already the books or notes. So be touch with the syllabus. Thank you listening me. Goodbye.